In this video, we will look at importing and exporting data into IronCAD. When you import data into IronCAD, you import it directly into the 3D scene. Since the 3D scene supports multiple parts inside of one file, we can easily import parts and assemblies into the 3D scene environment. To begin, we'll go ahead and click the import button, which is that little square icon up at the top there with the plus. We can also go to the file menu and select import, or we can also click on the assembly ribbon bar and click on the import button there. So you have three different ways of importing data. So we're going to go ahead and import the data, and we're going to import a SOLIDWORKS assembly. And you see here in the import drop-down list that we import a wide variety of different file types. For example, we bring in various solid model formats such as ACES and Parasolids and STEP. We bring in surface formats such as IGES. We also bring in a variety of facet model formats, including STL data. With our Trans add-on package, we also import other file formats such as Pro Engineer Parts and Assemblies, CATIA V5, Unigraphics, SOLIDWORKS, and Inventor files. So we support all the major file formats that are available today. So we go ahead and import the file, and you see here, if we look at the scene browser, that it's noticed that it is an assembly, so it's put the assembly icon next to it, and if we were to expand the assembly icon there, you'd see all the various parts. To export a part or assembly, you have a couple options. If you don't have anything selected, when you go to export, you'll be presented only with export formats that support a world environment. If you want to export a part or assembly, you must select it first. So we'll go ahead, we have our assembly here selected. To export, we can go to the assembly ribbon bar and choose export, or we can simply right-click on the assembly and choose export. And again, we get presented with a variety of different options for exporting. See, we support all the major file formats. We even export STL, so you can send data out to 3D printers. Another thing I'd like to show you are our import options when bringing in data. So you see here, when we go to import, we have an import options button. And we just simply click that, and we can see all the various options that can be adjusted when importing. We support things such as adding default colors for parts that don't have any color information applied to them. We can do a triangulated mesh. We can display error messages if there's any error messages. We can repair the bodies and simplify the bodies during the import process. Also, we have options on what to do if bad entities are found. Do we want to try and import them or abort the import operation or just ignore them? And then on the right, you can specify what types of data you'd like to import. Say you have a file that has a variety of different data formats in it. This can help you specify what you actually want to bring in during the import command. And if we continue, there are certain elements that can be changed based on the type of data that you're importing. So you have special settings that you can adjust for importing IGES data. We have settings for what to do with environmental data, settings for importing AutoCAD DXF data, settings for importing STL data, settings for importing ProEngineer data, and STEP. So that's a brief overview of the import and export capabilities of IronCAD, and that is the conclusion of this video.